Hello, this is Vanessa, and welcome back to Skipping with Jesus. I have a word from our Lord Jesus' voice. He spoke these words to me on the morning of February 23rd of 24 at 1:15 a.m. And the title of this spoken word is Great Sorrow with Great Separation. And this timestamp that he that I was awakened with, it ties into the written scripture that's married with this word, this spoken word of Jesus, and it's found in Mark 1:15 in the New Living Translation. And this is what it says: "The time promised by God has come at last," he announced. "The kingdom of God is near. Repent of your sins and believe the good news." Holy Spirit, I pray you put your hand on this spoken word that I might deliver it with the intent that it was spoken to me and I scribed it. Jesus, I am obedient to what you have asked of me to do, to release this spoken word you have given me. Holy Spirit, take over my voice, and in no way let me be part of this spoken word, but let it all the glory and honor go to Jesus, my Lord and my Savior. I pray this in Jesus' name. Here am I, Holy Spirit. Okay. Again, this is a little challenging word for me to deliver, but through the Holy Spirit, we will release it and know that in our hearts that it will not come back void. It will not come back to the author of this spoken word in Jesus, that it won't come back to him void. So anyway, this is what he said to me: "My children, are you ready for the reveal of my glory? Through the shifting I am doing within the church, a great separation will be established. Have you prepared your heart to be among those that will be unshaken? Standing on the firm foundation in me, the cornerstone? Or will you be among those that will be shifted out, having a heart of scarlet sin? There are many that will say, 'Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name? In your name perform miracles and cast out demons?' I will declare to you, depart from me, I never knew you. I have commanded you to have no other gods before me, yet you enter my house of worship, serving gods of your own making, contaminating the very place where praise is lifted up to me through my children's holy hands and pure hearts. Again, I say to you, choose you this day whom you will serve. Examine your heart, repent, and turn from your wicked ways before the divide of the great separation is completed. Then you will be either hot or cold, with it reward or judgment. As you make your decision, realize the lateness of the day. Are you hearing the cock crowing in the midnight hour? Will you be like my disciple Peter, denying you ever knew me when the cock crows for the third time, ending the third watch of the night? Dawn will break into the new day with you having denied me for the last time. On that day, the Father could tell his Son to go gather his bride. Oh, how often I have longed to gather you together as a hen gathers her chicks under her wings, but you were not willing. Great sorrow awaits you, religious frauds and pretenders. You are obsessed with peripheral issues. These matters are fine, yet you ignore the most important duties of all. to walk in the love of God, to display mercy to others, and to live with integrity. Readjust your values and place first things first, having me as your one and only God. Great sorrow awaits you, religious frauds and imposters. You are like one who will only wipe clean the outside of the cup, leaving the inside filthy. You are foolish to ignore the greed and self-indulgence that live like germs within you. You are blind to your evil. Shouldn't the one who cleans the outside also be concerned with cleaning the inside? You need to have more than clean dishes. You need to have a clean heart. Great sorrow awaits you, religious frauds and imposters. You are nothing more than tombs painted over with white paint. Tombs that look shining and beautiful on the outside, but filled with rotten corpses on the inside. Outwardly, you masquerade as righteous people, but inside your hearts, you are full of hypocrisy and lawlessness. To my remnant ecclesia, you can expect to be persecuted, for you will be hated because of your love for me. Many will stop following me and fall away. They will betray one another. The falling away has already begun. Many prophets will arise, deceiving multitudes, leading them away from the truth. There will be such an increase in the sin of lawlessness. Those whose hearts once burn with passion for God and others will grow cold. Hold your hope firmly to the end. You will experience life and deliverance. Through all of this, the good news of heaven's kingdom will be proclaimed all over the world, proclaiming a demonstration of the reality of God after the end of the age will arrive. Therefore, after hearing this, which side of the great separation will you find yourself on? Asked the Lord of angel armies. In Revelations 22:10-17, Amplified, we hear Jesus again. He said to me speaking of John, and this is Jesus, do not seal up the words of the prophecy of this book, for the time of their fulfillment is near. Let the one who does wrong still do wrong, and the one who is filthy, vile, and impure still be filthy, and the one who is righteous, just, and upright still be righteous, and the one who is holy still be holy. Behold, I, speaking of Jesus, am coming quickly, and my reward is with me to give to each one according to the merit of his deeds, earthly works, and faithfulness. I am Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end, the eternal one. Blessed, happy, prosperous, to be admired are those who wash their robes in the blood of Christ by believing and trusting in him, the righteous who do his commandments, so that they may have the right to the tree of life and may enter by the gates into the city. Outside are the dogs, the godless, the impure, those of low moral character, and the sorcerers with their intoxicating drugs and magic arts, and the immoral person, the perverted, the molester, and the adulterers, and the murderers, and the adulterates, and everyone who loves and practices lying, deception, and cheating. I, Jesus, have sent my angel to testify to you and give you assurance that these things for the churches. I am the root and the offspring of David, the radiant and bright morning star. The Spirit and the bride say, come. And the Spirit and the bride say, come, come, Lord Jesus, come. We pray, Lord, that you come quickly. Come quickly. Now, I pray God's blessing on this word, that it goes out to the fertile soil that the Holy Spirit has prepared. Now, I pray the Father finds us faithful and walking down those uncharted paths with his Son, remaining very hot for him and with a passion burning inside of us to see his glory and the righteousness of our Father spread throughout the world through his good news. Now, until next time, may God bless you and keep you, and may his face shine upon you. I love you all. Bye-bye.